Relative pronouns, pronombres relativos. They form relative clauses. Los pronombres y adjetivos relativos forman cláusulas relativas. A clause is made up of subject and one verb. Una cláusula está compuesta de un sujeto y un verbo. A sentence is made up of one clause or more clauses. Una oración está compuesta de una cláusula o más cláusulas. Relative clauses o cláusulas relativas me ayudan a complementar la información principal. Añade información descriptiva, es decir, que la especifica, y va en medio de la información principal. A veces va entre comas o después de una coma. También me ayuda a identificar de quién se está hablando al dar más información acerca del sustantivo o persona a la que nos estamos refiriendo, o también al tiempo o lugar al que nos estamos refiriendo. They are called relative because in a declarative sentence, they relate to a noun that has normally just been mentioned. They are called relative because in a declarative sentence, they relate to a noun that has normally just been mentioned before. Here down below, you have which are the relative pronouns. I told you about the woman who lives next door. I told you about the woman who lives next door. Do you see the cat which is lying on the roof? Do you see the cat which is lying on the roof? He couldn't read, which surprised me. He couldn't read, which surprised me. Do you know the boy whose mother is in ours? Do you know the boy whose mother is in ours? I was invited by the professor whom I met at the conference. I was invited by the professor whom I met at the conference. I don't like the table that stands in the kitchen. I don't like the table that stands in the kitchen. Pronombre relativo whom. Es un pronombre objeto que se utiliza para personas, especialmente en cláusulas relativas no definidas. En las cláusulas relativas definidas es preferible utilizar who. Por ejemplo, I was invited by the professor whom I met at the conference. I was invited by the professor whom I met at the conference. Fui invitado por el profesor a quien conocí en la conferencia. Pronombre relativo that. Es un pronombre sujeto u objeto para personas, animales o cosas en cláusulas relativas definidas. También es posible utilizar who o which. Por ejemplo, I don't like the table that stands in the kitchen. That stands in the kitchen. I don't like the table that stands in the kitchen. No me gusta la mesa que está parada en la cocina. Que está en la cocina. Who. Relative pronoun who. Se usa con personas y nos sirve para describir a la persona. Por ejemplo, I told you about the woman who lives next door. I told you about the woman who lives next door. Te dije acerca de la mujer que vive al lado. Pronombre relativo which, que también nos ayuda a hablar acerca de animales o cosas. Do you see the cat which is lying on the roof? Do you see the cat which is lying on the roof? Lying on the roof. ¿Ves el gato que está sobre el techo? Which también se refiere a una oración completa a la que ya se ha hecho referencia. Por ejemplo, he couldn't read, which surprised me a lot. He couldn't read, which surprised me a lot. Él no podía leer, lo que me sorprendió mucho. Pronombre relativo whose marca la posesión o pertenencia de las personas, animales o cosas. Por ejemplo, do you know the boy whose mother is a nurse? Do you know the boy whose mother is a nurse? ¿Conoces al muchacho cuya mamá es enfermera? Whom es un pronombre objeto para personas, especialmente en cláusulas relativas no definibles. En las relativas definibles son la por. This is the man who sold me a stolen mobile phone. This is the man who sold me a stolen mobile phone. There were several people at the party, whom I never met before. There were several people at the party whom I never met before. There were a lot of people at the party that I'd never met before. There were a lot of people at the party that I'd never met before. The machine, which had been running non-stop for 3 days, just stopped. The machine, which had been running non-stop for 3 days, just stopped. The machine that had been running non-stop for 3 days just stopped. The machine that had been running non-stop for 3 days just stopped. I know the man to whom you were talking. I know the man to whom you were talking. I was in a very complex situation from which I could see no way out. I was in a very complex situation from which I could see no way out. The events that occurred on Friday were rather alarming. The events that occurred on Friday were rather alarming. She's my sister whose cat ran away. She's my sister whose cat ran away. The children whose hands are dirty need to wash up. The children whose hands are dirty need to wash up. This is the family whose house is so big. This is the family whose house is so big. My neighbor, whose cats always annoy me, is in France. My neighbor, whose cats always annoy me, is in France. Taylor is the artist whose art is in New York. Taylor is the artist whose art is in New York. Property Brothers, in which two men act, is about people who buy houses. Property Brothers, in which two men act, is about people who buy houses. Loved or Lusted, in which a woman and a man also act, is about people who buy houses or move over to. Loved or Lusted, in which a woman and a man also act, is about people who buy houses or move over to. Multani, who is not deaf, knows LSM. Multani, who is not deaf, knows LSM. Multani, who can't speak, is an LSM translator. Multani, who can't speak, is an LSM translator. Thanksgiving, which is celebrated in USA and Canada, is a celebration when people get together to eat turkey and to give thanks for what they have. Thanksgiving, which is celebrated in the USA and Canada,
It's a celebration when people get together to eat turkey and to give thanks for what they have.
Thank you.